For this lesson, we'll talk about how to handle our order of operations ideas in the context of fractional problems. Now, when you simplify fractions, you always want to do the top and the bottom separately. Of course, our mathematical names for the top and the bottom of a fraction are the numerator and the denominator. What we'll actually do as we do these problems is separate the numerator and denominator, simplify both separately, and then we'll reduce the resulting fraction after the rest has been simplified. We'll simplify the top, we'll simplify the bottom, and then we'll take the resultant fraction and put it in lowest terms. So for our first example, it's a good idea to actually write the top and the bottom separately before you even do anything, so that you have a start point that is clearly defined. I'll begin with the numerator. Well, in this case, we have two parenthetical operations. Technically, we would do them from left to right, but since they're separate, you can really just do them at the same time. So I can just take 4 plus 5 and get 9. Then 2 minus 9 is negative 7, and 9 times negative 7 is negative 63. Then remember with the order of operations, we work the inside parenthetical first, and inside there we see we have an exponent and addition. The exponent, of course, comes first. So we'll have 2 squared, which is 4. So we'll have 2 cubed minus 4 plus 3. We'll do 4 plus 3, which we know is 7. We also know that 2 cubed is 8. And 8 minus 7 is 1. So this entire fraction, when we put this all together, is negative 63 divided by 1. Which is very easy to simplify, as that is just negative 63. We'll do the same thing with example 2 over here. So again, you want to write the entire top on its own, and you want to write the entire bottom on its own. And again, we begin with parentheses. Inside this parenthetical, we have addition and we have multiplication. Remember, multiplication comes first. So we will now have negative 4 squared minus 4 plus 6. At that point, we have negative 4 squared minus, well, 4 plus 6 is 10. Then here, remember, exponents only affect whatever they directly touch. That 2 is touching the 4, but this 2 has nothing to do with this negative here. That means you just square the 4 and leave the negative off to the side. You could think of it as negative 1 times 4 squared. And in the context of order of operations, you do the exponent before the multiplication. And so with that in mind, we will have negative 16 minus 10, which comes out to negative 26. As for the denominator, again, we begin with that parenthetical. 5 minus 4 is obviously 1. So we have 5 plus 3 times 1. We have multiplication and addition here. The multiplication comes first, so I get 5 plus 3, which is 8. And so in total here, I'll get negative 26 divided by 8. And then, again, we reduce this fraction to lowest terms. Well, 8 and 26 are both divisible by 2, so you'll get negative 13 fourths. So practice this with fractions. Just remember to write the numerator and denominator separately.